Balaam was a prophet about the time that Moses was coming through. Every now and again, God would speak to him, tell him what to say and do. He had a reputation in all those parts for being on the line of power. And when Moab's king heard Moses was coming, he called him in his needy hour. He said, Balaam, come and curse these Israelites. If you do, I believe I could beat them in a fight. But when Balaam asked the Lord said, Balaam, don't you go. Israel is blessed by me, don't you go mess up my show. But Balaam's head was turned by the money he could earn. So he saddled up his donkey anyway. Balaam and his servants hurried off for the king of Moab's castle. But they hadn't gone very far down the road when the whole trip became a hassle. Because the donkey ran off across a field, and then she nearly broke Balaam's ankle. But when she lay right down and wouldn't get up, Balaam got a little more than rankled. For the third time, Balaam beat her with his cane. But that donkey just refused to move again. It was the thing that happened next, though, made Balaam's knees get weak. That donkey still would not get up, but she began to speak. She said, Balaam, you're to blame. The way you beat me is a shame. 'Cause all I've done is tried to save your life. Then the angel of the Lord appeared with a flaming sword in his hand. And Balaam fell down on his face, a very frightened man. The angel said, Balaam, you'd be dead if your donkey hadn't detected that I was waiting there to part your hair when you and my sword connected. Balaam then repented for his sin, and he promised not to act like that again. And I hope we've learned our lesson now about God's reward for greed. But you know it's that talking donkey that's really strange indeed. Now that donkey's just a donkey, but she's still the thing God used. And that's the point I want you all to see. The Lord's the one who makes the choice of the instrument he's using. We don't know the reasons and the plans behind his choosing. So when the Lord starts using you, don't you pay it any mind. He could have used the dog next door if he'd been so inclined.